Hey, my name is Matt Johnson with whoismatt.com, and today I want to share with you three powerful video editing laptops that range in price from $1,500 to $3,000 plus. These laptops are capable of editing 4K, 6K, or even 8K video in Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve, or basically any other video editing software other than Final Cut, which is Mac only. They will also be good at sound mixing, 3D modeling, editing photos. Basically, any content creation or even gaming will be fantastic on them. That said, if you can't afford the roughly $1,500 starting price for one of these laptops, I want you to know that I've created a budget video editing laptop video that will show you laptops for under $1,000, one of which is only $650. Sound cool? I will link to that video in the corner and in the video description. All right, starting now with my cheapest video editing laptop recommendation, which also happens to be my favorite of this entire video, we have the Asus Zephyrus G15, which comes in at $1,500 at the time of recording. Asus took the laptop world by storm last year when they announced the G14 and took a lot of the power you see in a bulky gaming laptop and crammed it into a much smaller body that still had surprisingly good thermals. Now, they've improved on the G14 with the G15 by increasing the screen size by 1 inch and adding even more powerful graphics cards. I personally love the G15 because it combines a ridiculously powerful AMD 5900HS 8-core 16-thread CPU with a very nice and color-accurate 165Hz 1440p screen that feels made for color correcting and color grading video. You also get a ton of ports with this laptop, including USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A and Type C, a microSD card reader, and HDMI. I do want you to be aware, though, that there are some drawbacks to this laptop. Namely, the G15 does not have a webcam, but the bigger con is this laptop does not support Thunderbolt. So if you're someone that uses a lot of Thunderbolt hard drives to edit from, you're going to want to look at one of the other laptop options in this video. Also, I want you to be aware that Asus sells multiple versions of this laptop, so it's important for you to buy one with the correct specs. At the very least, you want the option with the NVIDIA RTX 3060 and 16GB of RAM, which you can then upgrade yourself to 32GB. Like I said though, that RTX 3060 is the minimum that I would recommend for 4K video editing. But if you have a larger budget and you want to edit video that's higher resolution than 4K, like 6K or 8K, RAW video, etc., upgrading to the G15 with the NVIDIA RTX 3070 or 3080 inside is a great choice. But you do need to be aware that it will potentially add thousands to the cost of this laptop. Also, in regards to battery life for this laptop, and really battery life for all of the laptops in this video, we'll knock them all out right now. Regardless of what the manufacturer claims, when it comes to video editing, which is a very intensive process that requires a lot of processor and a lot of hard drive reading, and generally a bright screen for color correction and color grading, don't expect anything near what the manufacturer claims for battery life. In my experience, regardless of the claimed battery life, I would expect anywhere from 3 to 5 hours. Lastly, in regards to the G15, I want to help you out if you don't quite have the budget for it. If $1,500 is a bit too much to spend for you, I would recommend looking at the Asus G14 that came out in 2020. At the time of making this video, the G14 is selling for as low as $1,100, and it is still an extremely powerful machine with a great screen that will easily edit 4K video. I think it is a great budget option if you can find it. Moving on to the second laptop option now, I'm going to recommend that you check out the Gigabyte Aero 15, which comes in at $1,700 at the time of making this video. Similar to the Asus G15, this is another laptop that crams a ton of power into a relatively lightweight and compact body. Unlike the Asus, this laptop uses an Intel chip, but it still has 8 cores and 16 threads of performance and should perform similarly to the G15. The big pro of the Gigabyte over the Asus, and the main reason it costs more, is that this laptop includes a 4K OLED screen. OLED screens are some of the best and highest quality screens you can buy today, with phenomenal colors, fantastic contrast, and you can expect a near perfect experience when it comes to color correcting and color grading using this screen. In addition, you get 16 gigabytes of RAM that is user upgradable, 3 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports, 1 HDMI port, an SD card reader, and unlike the G15, you get a Thunderbolt port and a webcam too. Like the G15, the Gigabyte also has upgraded models as well, but I'm warning you now, the price goes up very quickly, from $1,700 for the RTX 3060 model to an eye-watering $3,500 for the 3080. But as a plus, that model does come with 64 gigabytes of RAM and a faster CPU. Overall, both of these laptops from Asus and Gigabyte walk the thin line between being a gaming powerhouse and a content creation device. And I think you can't go wrong with either option. Personally, if I had the budget, I would go with the Gigabyte for the OLED screen. The last laptop that I'm going to recommend for you is a bit different. And this laptop prioritizes a thinner and cleaner looking form factor at the expense of a bit of performance. At $2,800 at the time of making this video, I'm going to recommend the Dell XPS 15, which is a model of laptop that I've used for several years and only have positive things to say. While the specific model of the XPS 15 that I recommend costs definitely more than the other two laptops, I would consider the XPS 15 closest to a MacBook in terms of style and build quality. You're still getting an 8-core, 16-thread CPU, but unlike the previous options, you're only getting an RTX 3050 Ti inside, which isn't quite as powerful as the graphics cards in the previous laptops. As I said though, you are getting a more compact laptop that still comes with a 4K OLED screen option as well that is very color accurate. So, if you're somebody that travels a lot like me, and you want a good amount of power in a compact form factor that you can throw in your bag, that's why the XPS 15 is on this list. The XPS 15 also includes 3 USB-C ports, 2 of which are Thunderbolt 3, and an SD card reader. Alternatively, Dell has also recently released the XPS 17, which is very similar to the XPS 15, but as the name implies, it has a 17-inch screen and starts at $150 more. It also has better cooling with a vapor chamber, which will definitely help out on long video renders, as well as a more powerful graphics card with an RTX 3060 inside. If you want to know more about this laptop, I've actually created an entire review about the 2020 model of it, which I will link to in the corner and description. With that, those are 3 video editing laptops that I really like and recommend, but just like my budget video editing laptop video, we are not quite done yet, because I want to take a brief moment to talk about the laptops we're seeing from Apple. In the past, Apple laptops have cost a premium for a device that's relatively underpowered compared to the competition. Don't even get me started on the keyboards, which were mediocre until they were finally updated in 2020. Goodbye forever, butterfly. But I digress. All of this has changed with Apple's newest laptops with their Apple Silicon chips. At the time of making this video, the only Apple laptops that exist with the M1 chip are the MacBook Air and the MacBook Pro 13-inch. These are both very impressive laptops, especially the MacBook Air that comes in right at $999. Of course, we can assume that Apple will be coming out with more powerful laptops featuring Apple Silicon in the future, especially a 16-inch model that will replace their current Intel-based 16-inch laptop. And if I had to bet, I would bet there is a pretty good chance that these new Apple laptops will be incredibly competitive with these PC options that I've told you about, if not outright beating them in basically every performance metric. So that said, if you're watching this video right when it comes out and Apple hasn't revealed their new laptops, you may want to wait a bit before you buy a new laptop, just so you can see what Apple has up their sleeve. And if you're watching this video later and Apple's new laptops are already out, make sure you watch some reviews about them as well, because I'm betting they're going to end up being Very impressive. I am planning on creating some videos about these new Apple laptops whenever they come out, so please consider subscribing if you want to see them. With that, those are three video editing laptops, as well as some upgrades, and a slight detour to talk about Apple's laptops as well. Now, to be clear, these are not the only laptops that are capable of editing video. There are many other brands and models out there, but these are some of my favorites. I really hope this video has been helpful and informative to you if you're considering purchasing a video editing laptop. All of the laptops that I've talked about today are linked down in the video description if you want to check them out. And if, after watching this video, you're thinking to yourself, dang, I can't afford these laptops. In that case, that is where my budget video editing laptop buyer's guide is going to come in handy, which is going to show you budget laptops for video that are under $1,000 and as low as $650. That video is linked down below if you want to watch it. Lastly, what if you find yourself primarily editing from home? In that case, I would highly recommend saving money and building your own video editing computer. My latest build guide video will show you all the parts you need to buy to build a 4K video editing PC for only $750. I have another video that will then show you every step of how to put it together. Those videos are linked down below. With that, thank you so much for watching and have a great day.